Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Age Gap Love Story. This is episode 37, and we are Carrie and Alan. We're a married couple who has a 32 and a half year age difference, and we started this YouTube channel and podcast to offer support and information and community to our other age gap couple friends. And today's episode comes from a question we got from our listeners, and it's all about overcoming the fear of getting dumped for a younger partner. So this specifically today is going to apply to the fears of the older partner getting dumped by their younger partner for somebody else. And just a few housekeeping things. I want to let you guys know that we are really trying to publish every other week. So you can expect two new videos slash podcast episodes a month. And I upload the video to YouTube, and then I take the audio and I put it on all the podcast formats. So whether you're on Apple Podcasts or whatever the Android podcast app is, you can find us there. At Age Gap Love Story, which makes it more convenient if you just want to listen in the car or whatever. And you can always find us on Instagram at Age Gap Love Story and on Facebook. We have a private Facebook group, so you can find that in the description. And just be sure to answer the questions, and then I'll approve you to join the group. And we would love to see you there. That's really the best way to connect with us and to ask questions. So, as I mentioned, we got a question today. I'm not going to share the person's name who asked us just because I said I would keep that private. But essentially, she is a woman in an age gap relationship. Her partner is a man who's older and they are not married. But her partner, I think she said, is between 20 to 30 years older. And he has a fear of her leaving him for a younger man, or let's say somebody her own age. And so I thought that would be kind of interesting to discuss. And we do have an episode. Let's see, I wrote it down. I think it's episode 17, where we talked about some of our tips if you are moving into a relationship, an age gap relationship after you've been divorced, and maybe you're even thinking about getting married. We talked about some of our best tips about how to recover from divorce and prepare yourself for another serious relationship. So I've been talking a lot. I thought maybe we should just, maybe you could just talk briefly about, we talked about this last night about how you. Somebody told you, oh, what if Carrie leaves you for a younger man, and kind of how you address that within yourself. And then we're gonna jump into some basically three pieces of advice that we have. But I thought it might be interesting to talk about your experience with dealing with this fear.
My
Want
turn.
to?
My
Yeah,
turn.
your turn.
My turn. Well, as Carrie said, when Carrie and I were dating, and I would say becoming quite close, a friend of mine at the time, who was about my age, as Carrie said, had suggested that at some point I might be left by myself, and Carrie might take off and find somebody closer to her age or somebody who was romantically more appealing than I was after I had become dependent on her. And so I gave it some thought because it was a reasonable consideration. And I thought about it for a while as I became closer to Carrie. And as I knew her better, I felt that her sincerity and attachment to me was really genuine, and I thought it would last. However, I tried to be realistic, and I did think that if she did leave at some point in the future, emotionally, that I would be able to deal with it and move on and again try to restart and find another relationship. However, we had so many things in common, and we were so simpatico, so to speak, I just felt that it wouldn't happen, and was hopeful that it wouldn't. And I made every effort and continue to make every effort that Carrie and I continue in a positive, loving relationship, and that we encourage each other to stay connected. And frankly, I have never been tempted in the 20 some years we've been a couple, both before and after marriage, to think about another woman in any way, shape, or form. And I think Carrie's pretty much felt the same way because we offer so much to each other. And I think you can get a sense, particularly if you're the older person and you have experience in relationships and life, and you have a sense of maturity and common sense, that you are able to judge a person's sincerity, and gauge whether or not they are really going to be glued to you, so to speak, for the long term.
Good. And I do want to say that this is kind of a complex issue. As Alan and I started, we were thinking about the question and we started to dive into it, we realized that we can answer things like these types of questions based on our experience. But sometimes these questions, I think, are indicative of maybe like deeper issues. And so, and we always say that we're not therapists. And so if you feel like if you have like really intense anxiety around any of these issues, we always want to refer you to professional therapy. We think professional therapists are trained to have the skills and like more of the background and really helpful information. So we'll give you our best advice based on our experience, but if you find that it's not helpful or it makes things worse, hopefully that's not the case. We do think that relationship therapists or whatever professional therapists can really offer a lot more
Right,
than we can.
because there may be deeper issues than reasons expressed. For example, the older person indicating that he was concerned about going forward with a relationship because of this fear that the younger person might depart, his real, maybe even subliminal, not completely understood on a conscious level, fear is really not so much that as a fear of her departure, but a fear of making a commitment. So, I mean, there could be deeper issues. And as Carrie said, somebody who's a skilled therapist can sort of get at the root cause.
Yeah. So I think today we really just want to talk about kind of three main ways to think about this issue of worrying about your younger partner leaving you. And I think we're going to talk about, first of all, just the idea of jealousy and anxiety in the relationship. Next, we want to talk about the second, that issue of second marriages and like recovering from divorce or a bad breakup. And then Alan and I are going to talk about maybe just again a little bit more about how we maintain trust with each other. And so this type of anxiety doesn't become an issue. So I think, first of all, I'm sorry, I have to move the cat. There you go. Okay. And this person who emailed me this question, I sent her back some resources, and the first resource that I came across is this Instagram account that I've known about for a while, and it's called At the Secure Attachment, and she's a professional therapist, and I think she has some amazing information. And essentially, this fear of your partner leaving you, whether it's you're in an age gap relationship or not. The way I understand it is it comes from something called attachment theory, and it describes how, or it comes out of people having maybe trauma in their past, maybe even going back to childhood, or as more recently, maybe you've gone through a divorce or a bad breakup, and so you have what's called attachment trauma, and so that can manifest in future relationships as jealousy or anxiety about being left for somebody else. And so there's ways to resolve this attachment trauma. And that Instagram account, I think, provides some amazing information. And I think is a good example of what a professional therapist could provide. But I also, as Alan and I talked more about this question and how to address it, it became kind of clear to me that the two, well, this is how I think of it. I'm not sure if it's true or not, but the two main anxieties I think can manifest in an age gap relationship once you really start to become attached to the person is for the younger person, you worry about losing your older partner. And we addressed this in an episode we called Death Anxiety, How to Deal with the Fear of Losing Your Older Partner. And you can look for that episode. But then from the older person's perspective, their worst fear is probably being left for their by their younger partner for somebody else. And so you can see that, but in both cases, it comes from an anxiety about losing your partner. And then so if you dig deeper into that anxiety, it really, I think, comes out of the anxiety of being alone or being disappointed or having your heart broken. And so maybe that anxiety isn't so much about your partner actually finding somebody else. If you dig a little bit deeper, the anxiety is about being alone. So being alone when you're in your 80s or falling in love and having your heart broken. So like just digging a little bit deeper, if you start to address that fear of being alone, whether you are the older partner or the younger partner, then you start to realize there's some ways that you can soothe yourself. Like, for example, as an older partner, if your fear is that you're going to be alone when you're in your 80s or 90s because your younger partner left you, well, maybe you do a little bit of planning. So you think, well, there's services like home health services. So if you're worried about just being alone, you could always have somebody come check on you, whether that's a family member or like a home health service where you're actually paying somebody to come and make sure that you're safe and you have food prepared and things like that.
And keeping family close.
Yeah, or making sure that you continue to have friendships. So if your partner is gone for whatever reason, that you have people around you, so you're not totally alone, like, because that's the fear of being alone. Or maybe you continue to develop your own hobbies and things, outside of the relationship or in the relationship. Like maybe you continue to be part of a group or a church or a physical activity like a tennis or even like playing chess or just activities. So that fear becomes a little bit lessened because you realize, yeah, I can take, I, no matter what, I can take care of myself. Because the bottom line is, we can't control what happens tomorrow. We can't control other people. So whether, and we just can't control life. We just do the best that we can. But Alan can't control me. I can't control him. And we can't control unfortunate things that happen in life, just accidents and horrible things, that we just have no control over. So the only way to really deal with uncertainty is just to,
Adapt.
yeah, to and have built some confidence that to know that no matter what happens, you will have resources, you will have support, and you'll be okay.
Life goes on.
Right.
And whether life goes on in a positive way or a negative way, the answer is always right here. Now, every day when you get up and you look in the mirror, you have to decide whether today's going to be a good day or today's going to be a bad day. And the person who makes that decision and brings that about is you. So I know it sounds easy, and I know it isn't, but all of us have to make an effort to try to control what we can. And what we can't control, we have to deal with it.
Yeah, and the only thing we can control is ourselves and our minds. So the second kind of issue that came up for us when we were thinking about this question is just the idea that if you've been through a divorce or a really bad breakup, you're probably going to have some trauma. And if you're going to take that into your new relationship and, you know, you're telling your new partner, oh, yeah, but you're going to leave me for somebody else, like you're bringing that from your previous relationship. It's not really fair to your new partner, especially if, you know, he or she is seems very devoted to you. So I would say that that's something that you really should deal with from with therapy. Or there are some great books about like recovering from divorce, recovering from bad breakups. So I would take that to heart and realize, like, you know, you're going to have to do the work to recover from your breakup and make yourself prepared for a fresh new relationship. You don't want to put that on to your new partner.
Yeah, and enjoy it. I mean, you move forward, pull out of that new relationship all the wonderful things you can. If it's not working out, well, then it's probably not a good new relationship. But as Carrie said, you know, you can't let the old spoil the new. So, you know, you've got to make a break. You have to move forward. It's all in here. You've got to make that effort.
And I mean, if you've been cheated on, that's horrible. And it is very traumatic. But it doesn't mean that you'll be cheated on again. But I do think you need to get some help to recover from that trauma, because that is incredibly painful. And, you know, just even going through a divorce is so traumatic. So you need to do some work before you get into another relationship. But if you're finding like these anxieties are coming up and they're kind of unfounded, you know, your new partner isn't cheating on you and she's assuring you that she loves you and she doesn't want to meet a younger man. She's happy with you.
Right. And people don't want to listen to a whiner. You know, if you have complaints or you have issues, you have to address them. Don't whine to your new partner about this being a problem or that being a problem, or, you know, move ahead.
Yeah. I mean, you don't want to poison that relationship, and you can. And
you can very easily.
Yeah. So
don't rag on your ex either. I mean, that's behind you. I mean, don't say, well, this happened to me, but when I was married to so-and-so and she did this or he did that. Hey, forget about it. You know, you're opening a new door.
Yeah. And we don't need to sound callous. We know this can be incredibly painful.
It's tough. There's no doubt about it being tough, but you know, you're out there looking for a new person, or you have found a new person for a reason. And that reason has got to be an important reason in your life. So, you know, grasp it, move ahead with it, you know, take the change, seize the day, as they say.
Yeah. And I think also there's like a mindset shift. If you have in your mind, like, I'm a victim, you know, even if it's subconscious that, you know, my partner always cheats on me, my partner always leaves me, it's almost like, you don't want to turn your life into a self-fulfilling prophecy. You really want to, you know, wake up every day that, you know, I'm lovable. I'm capable of having a committed, long-term, happy relationship, right? Because you are.
Yeah, do a little personal makeover. You know, make yourself a different person, a better person.
And you have to do that in your own mind. Nobody else can do it for you. Okay.
Yes.
And then I thought Alan and I should just talk about the way that we deal with this potential issue. And I think Alan and I also discussed the idea that, you know, we have the perspective of an older man and a younger woman. There's, of course, many other different types of age gap relationships where there's an older woman and a younger man, or two men or two women, or, you know, trans partners. So we cannot know so much about that dynamic. So we do talk about the older man, younger women, but we also want to, share with you that we do appreciate that there's a lot of diversity in age gap relationships. It's just that our perspective is the older man, younger woman. We don't want to pretend to know, what it's like for you if you're an older woman and a younger man. Maybe that there's different issues, and please feel free to, enlighten us, leave us a comment or message us if we're missing something
Right. Or
here.
if you had an experience that you'd like us to share with others, something that we've missed, let us know.
Yeah, so, but we do want to say, like, for instance, I want to say, because this message, I guess if I'm speaking to another older man who's thinking his wife is going to maybe leave him, I want to say to you that I'm just saying from me as a woman, like, my attraction to a man is not all, I mean, there's some physical attraction, but really, I think I've read that, like, for a lot of women, the attraction to a man is really less about the physical appearance. It's more about, like, how a man makes you feel and how a man, or your partner, how you communicate with each other, how he does little things for you. And, like, there's just, so the idea that I'm gonna leave Alan for a younger man, it'd be, to me, it's not, that's really not an issue, like the issue of attraction. It'd be more like if Alan and I lost the ability to communicate, or we just didn't get along anymore, that would be, to me, a lot more worrisome than me just, like, seeing some young guy on the street. Like, to me, there's just, like, I mean, I was young, I dated other men my age, so I've been with 20-year-old men when I was in my 20s, and they were extremely immature. Like, there was a reason that I did not end up marrying someone my own age. I ended up marrying Alan because, he was mature, and
I was as mature at least as a 21-year-old.
and we got along so well. So I guess, to me, that is almost, it's just not even a consideration that I would be attracted to a younger man, because there just would be no connection. I mean, anyway, so I just thought I would throw that out there, because it's almost like, I can see why a man, an older man, would think that, but it's really not an issue. And then just also maybe the idea of me connecting or leaving Alan for somebody my age, I guess that might be a more reasonable concern. And again, it would be if Alan and I, if our relationship wasn't so strong and we were fighting all the time. That might be an issue, but just the idea of me leaving him for someone my own age. There's also some things that I do that I've done ever since we were a couple, and that I would do in any time of type of serious relationship, whether, I was with Alan or with anybody else. And, like, for instance, I don't have, like, I'm not friends with my exes. I'm not going out with girlfriends who are single, and going into, like, situations where there are a lot of single men who are trying to hook up.
I think the bottom line is it's so hard to find somebody that you like and you're compatible with, that whether it's the younger person, the older person, is that leaving that compatible relationship just because somebody else has a more physical attraction, that's very short term and it's not going to last. What will last is a compatible, happy, interacting, good communication environment that you're going to have with the person you have now. So think about that old expression, the grass always looks greener on the other side of the fence, but it may taste bitter when you bite it.
I didn't hear that second part of it.
Ruff.
Yeah, and I mean, I think also we've done some videos, like, what we've learned after We had one, what we've learned after 24 years together, just about like keeping the romance alive and staying connected and stuff like that. So I hope that kind of answered that question. And
I hope so too, because I'm
yeah.
ready for lunch.
Okay. Yeah. So it is getting near lunchtime and
Yes.
Alan lives by his stomach. So we hope that you enjoyed this episode. We hope to be back in another couple of weeks. And again, like we love answering your questions or your concerns. So feel free to email us. Keep the emails coming, keep the comments coming.
And any comments or requests, whatever we hear from you, we keep strictly confidential.
Yeah.
Nobody else is going to see it. Nobody's going to have any clue who you are or what you asked us about. I want to assure you of that.
Right. So thank you for watching and listening, and we'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.